Yeah, I'm Heather Raich. I'm the director of the Amelia Earhart Birthplace Museum, and we're at the childhood home of Amelia Earhart. She was also born here in 1897. The room we're standing in is Amelia Earhart's birth room. It's pretty spectacular to be able to be in the same room that she was born in. Her grandpa purchased a one-room cabin in 1861, and he added on for 12 years. He just wanted to make a roomy home for all of his family. The last room he added in 1873 was really spectacular, and that's the dining room, and I'm so glad that he continued to build on. That's one of the really nice things about the museum is you could look at old things, you know, back in the time. You could look in things from, you know, theories. You could look at fashion designs, and there's just so much to Amelia that she accomplished in her 39 years. Yeah, the handprint downstairs was done by a lady, a palm reader, and you can kind of compare. We have it laid out, and Amelia had really long fingers, and on that the palm reader told her that she didn't take unnecessary risks when she was reading her palm, which I guess you could take it in two ways. One, she was totally wrong. Two, Amelia didn't think maybe it was an unnecessary risk. People need to know that even whenever you start and where you're from, you could always build, and if you're determined to do something, you can. The town really loved Amelia. She even came back for a parade, and she loved the town. We even had a dentist's office that changed our name to Canary Dental, and that was one of her planes, which was she called the Canary. Her dad took her on a flight, and she said it was $10 for 10 minutes. He paid for the flight. She went up, and she said after 200 to 300 feet up, she said, "That's what I gotta do." And right after that, she started raising money to fly. She wasn't one to give up. And even when you talk about her world flight, her first attempt failed. And not a lot of people realize that she crashed her plane when she was taken off from Hawaii and really kind of had to start over. All the things that she accomplished, you know, she had hardships too, but she got back up and went again.
Let us know what your favorite part of this video was in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. Also, you can follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and be sure to subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.